today I wanted to do a little video, since summer is here, on basically tips to help boost your confidence over summer. I don't know about you, but I really have a hard time, like, after winter, it's normally easy to kind of, I guess, hide my body and feel a little bit more able to hide more things that, like, I don't like about myself. But when summer comes, of course, comes tank tops, bikinis, or bathing suits, or shorts, and I think a lot of people's insecurities tend to come out. So today, I wanted to give you just kind of my five. I wanted to give you five tips to kind of help boost your confidence this summer. Now, this goes for anybody, any size, any color, any shape, because I know that everyone kind of comes with their own insecurities. I have friends that are super, super thin that are just as insecure that friends that are quite larger than I am. So I just wanted to kind of talk to you girls and guys about, you know, ways that we can boost our confidence. Number one, buy a suit you feel comfortable in. Now, I know, especially on YouTube, there's kind of this big boost for, like, plus size ladies to strut their stuff in bikinis, or anybody in general, but I notice it is becoming more common for that, or at least that's what I see on YouTube. I honestly think that's awesome. I think, you know, be comfortable in your skin, because that is important, and you shouldn't have to miss out because you don't feel good about yourself. But I also say, you know what, maybe it's a cool tankini that you like, or just a one piece. Even if, you know, you're not going out, you don't have to be going out in a bikini to be like, oh look, I'm confident. But if you feel good in what you're wearing, and even if you're not comfortable wearing a bathing suit, but like maybe a cute swim dress, or even like a bathing suit with a nice cover up on it, anything to get you to feel better about yourself when you're at the beach around with other people or at the pool is better. It makes me feel better whenever I have something that fits me right and I feel good in. So my first biggest tip is buy a bathing suit that you feel good in, and don't let what other people say dictate what you wear, because I know you might have friends that might say, oh yeah, that looks great, but if you don't feel comfortable in it, don't wear it, and it's okay. Buy a suit that you feel good and you feel comfortable in. Number two, maybe do like a little refresh on your wardrobe. Now, you don't have to go out and buy a whole new wardrobe, but maybe see, either you can like see what kind of pieces you have and see if you can kind of mix them up. I've seen a lot of really cool videos on YouTube where they tell you, show you kind of ways to mix and match clothes to kind of change up your style. Or, you know, I love H&M, Forever 21, and Maurice's all have really cute stuff for relatively inexpensive. So I like to go there, and even if it's just picking out like a cute new outfit that you feel good in, I think that always helps me to feel a little bit better about myself. You know, you want to feel good in what you wear. Tip number three, do something fun. Maybe an adventure, maybe something that you've never done before. I think for me, like, getting out and doing stuff, and when you're in the moment, it's a lot harder for me to sit there and focus on like my flaws or compare myself. I struggle with that so much, comparing myself to other people. So if you go out and like go on an adventure, go for a hike, go to the beach, to the pool, or even just go on like a little road trip, I think that really helps kind of bring up our confidence and also just kind of help you focus on something other than maybe what you're feeling. Number four, try to stop negative thoughts about yourself. I struggle with this a lot. I struggle a lot with just, I'm a natural, I like to say realist, but realistically I'm pretty pessimistic a lot of the time. I think for me, what helps me to kind of get out of like a negative self-talk is to start focusing on things that, like if I'm at a party and I'm feeling really uncomfortable, or I'm feeling like, you know, like I'm not good enough, because that's my biggest struggle, I start to focus on the food or the drinks, or even just like thinking about the weather, or even just focusing on, you know, something else that's there that helps to kind of, sometimes if you just focus on like where you're at in the moment, it kind of helps you kind of slow down or halt that negative self-talk. So that would be tip number four, which I think is really important. Tip number five, which I've heard, know you've heard the phrase, fake it till you make it. Well, in some ways, I agree with that. In other ways, I think it all boils down to just focusing on the positives. Play up the things that you like about yourself. If you have awesome hair, maybe you do, you know, your makeup like a pro. Maybe you have really cute nails. Think about the things that you like about yourself. And when you're looking at yourself in the mirror, try to focus on like the things that you like, because it's so easy, and I struggle with it too, to focus and nitpick the things that I don't like. So I really hope that those tips were helpful for you guys. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of my videos, please don't forget to subscribe over here somewhere. And tell me some other ways that you guys help, you know, boost your confidence in the comments below, or even give me a video response of ways that you boost your confidence and link it in the comments below. I'd love to watch them. So let me know what you guys think, and don't forget, see you guys next time.